Let's begin the actual demonstration of the use case. This use case, the presenters will be me, Anesis Sidiropoulos, Yannis Poulakis, Petros and Sofia Karagiorgou, and of course, later on, Richard Macready as well. So, as briefly introduced before by Maurizio, the GFT collaborated with an insurance company based in Italy, and the actual use case comprises of two main scenarios, which include the proton recommendation and prediction. The UI flow for this use case, as you can see, we start with the process modeler by the invocation of a business analyst, where we create the high-level graph, and we set up the overall objectives. And then later on, this use case has also to offer is the invocation of the process mapping component for a further algorithmic assessment. And then later on, we'll pass on the data toolkit to fine-tune the SLOs and the constraints. And later on, move on the dimensioning workbench to see the parameter tuning and the recommendation calculation. And last but not least, of course, to the adaptive visualizations part, where we will start receiving metrics and visualize them in graphs and charts. So, to begin with, as you can see here, the first step of the invocation is the process modeler. So, business analyst logs in the process, logs in big data stack, and in the process modeler tab, starts creating this graph. For this use case, we're going to have nodes. We're going to have a data filter node. We're going to have a feedback collector node, a model update, and a recommendation service. So we're going to use these four nodes. Let me make it a little bit more visible. Great. So the nodes, the process modeler has been created with the logic to follow some rules and constraints that does not allow every node to be connected with everything. So for this use case, we also define these constraints being able to connect these four nodes. Let me just put some indicative identifier names as well. Great. In for each one of these nodes, they can furtherly fine tweak and fine tune them and make the selections around the node attributes. And last but not least, the user will of course set the overall objective. Let's assume that this one is the accuracy. We also provide a namespace. It's as showcased in the previous use case demos, the user can, of course, export the graph. But in our use case, we are going to send this high-level representation of the graph towards the process mapping component. The process mapping was some error here. The process is that we send the graph to the process mapping, and then we go on with what's happening here. But as I can see, I don't know, maybe is the service up and running, Yannis?
Yeah, I think last night it was working, but now there seems to be some kind of error.
Can we restart it maybe and try again?
Yeah, just give me a minute.
Okay.
I will move forward with the slide. So after the business analyst has concluded creating a graph that depicts his analytical needs in the process modeling environment, the generated graph is ingested by the process mapping component to later on be propagated to the data toolkit. When the process mapping is flagged for execution, the component will automatically associate abstract machine learning tasks in the graph that are supported with a specific algorithm and set of input parameters that are expected to perform well for the data at hand. Within the smart insurance use case, process mapping targets classification on a dataset that provides information on the probability of insurance customers terminating their contract, also known as the churn prediction problem. In order to tailor this functionality to the use case at hand, process mapping first assesses some key aspects in the graph, such as which are the data that are subject for analysis, the machine learning task to be performed on the data, and whether that is also supported by process mapping, and the overall objective as defined in the previous step in the process modeling environment. Afterwards, according to the objectives defined, a pre-trained machine learning model, also known as the meta-learner, that is capable of algorithm selection, is loaded, and its respective input is clearly defined. Its respective input is a series of meta-features that are extracted from the data set at hand, that is the subject of analysis, and these are provided to the meta learner in order to provide us with a prediction. Recall that in an offline phase we have executed a handful of algorithm configurations on a variety of data sets that allowed us to create these machine learning models, these meta learners that are able to suggest the best performing algorithm. Later on, the graph is propagated to the data toolkit, and I will pass the floor to Petros.